Hello, my name is Todd Baginski. I'm a Microsoft MVP and the CTO of Canvas Consulting. In this video, I'm going to give you an end-to-end demonstration of the Help Desk PowerApps sample. All right, let's get started. After you've installed the Help Desk PowerApps sample, go to web.powerapps.com, click on the Apps menu, and then click on the Help Desk PowerApps sample you've installed. Once you load it, it will look like this. I'm going to walk you through the flow of being a help desk user by logging in with the top button here to submit a ticket. After I submit a ticket, I will then log in as a help desk admin. These are people who work on the help desk and facilitate fixing tickets for users. I'm going to show you the emails that flow back and forth and the flow that is used to facilitate this process. First thing I'd like to show you is the SharePoint list behind the scenes. This is what my help desk list looks like. This list stores my help desk tickets. Right now, you can see it's empty. The first time you open the app and log in as a help desk user or an admin, it will also be empty unless you've put any data inside of that help desk list. First, I'll click Login as a help desk user. I can see that I have not submitted any help desk tickets. When you log in as a user, the view is filtered to show just the tickets that you have submitted. I click the plus button to submit a new ticket. Now I enter the title for my ticket. Then I select a category. These categories, as well as the priorities, both come from the choice columns inside of the SharePoint list. So if you wish to change the values inside of them, you don't have to write any code. You just select the different values for the items in your choice list. Then I'll select the priority. First, I'm going to select a low priority item. And then I give it a description and click the Create button. When I click the Create button, my ticket is now submitted to the help desk, and if I come back to the SharePoint list and refresh the page, I will see that item has been created here. Now I can return to the help desk Power App, and I can see that ticket is inside of the list, but no customer service representatives at the help desk have started working on it. I'll then click the logout button and now log back in as a help desk admin. So now I'm pretending I'm a user who is part of the help desk team. I can see that a ticket has been assigned to us and it hasn't been started, so I'm going to get to work on it. I'm going to click the edit button to begin my work. Then I'll say I have started on that and it is in progress. Notice the slider moves automatically when I pick which value that I'm working with. Then I'm going to pick who this is assigned to. Here, I type in the name of the user. In this case, I'm logged in with this admin account. I'm using it as both the admin and the help desk user so I can show you the emails that flow back and forth between the two different users. This person indicates they have started work on the ticket and is in progress, and they've assigned it to a user, and then they will click update. Now you can see the progress is updated to in progress. If I come back and log in as the help desk user, here I can also see the ticket is in progress. If I click over to look at Outlook, remember I'm using the same account here to be both the person who submitted the ticket as well as the help desk employee who's taking care of it. So I'm going to see all the emails going back to both of those people in the same email account. First, when we submitted our ticket, we can see here that the administrator has a new ticket that was assigned to them. And this is marked as a low priority item. You can see the SLA indicates we must get back to the user within 24 hours. Then, when the user started to work on the ticket, an email was sent back to the person who submitted it to tell them the ticket is being worked on. If we click on the link here, it takes them to the list item in the SharePoint list called Help Desk. I'd like to show you more about the SLA that we're displaying here in the bottom of the email when a ticket has been assigned. To do that, I'm going to return to the Power App, log out, and come back as a Help Desk user and submit another ticket and give it a high priority instead of a low one. Here I enter a title, I pick my category, I select high priority, and now I'll give it a description. Then I can click create, and again, I've created a new ticket and submitted it. You can see it is not started. Coming back to the SharePoint list and refreshing the page, I can now see the new high priority item I submitted to the application. Returning to Outlook, I can see now I have an email that indicates there's a ticket to work on. Notice this one is marked as a high priority item, and the SLA indicates I need to work on this one in 4 hours or less to meet our help desk SLA. Well, I better get to work on that, so I'm going to return to the Power App and do so. First, I will log out as the help desk user and log back in as the admin. Notice my high priority ticket is not started and begin work. I'll select a user to assign it to, in this case, myself, and I will mark this one as in progress and update it. Now I'm working on the ticket. Again, if I head to Outlook, now I will see a notification message that indicates my ticket is being worked on. As I work through the ticket, I realize I can't fix their keyboard unless I know which type of keyboard they have. So here, I will come back in and I will set a new status. The new status I will select is waiting on CSR, and then I will put in a description to tell them what I need. Finally, I will update the ticket and it will go back into the system, and you can see the status is marked as waiting on CSR. Returning to Outlook, I can now see that the user who submitted the ticket they are asking for more information about it in order to solve the problem. I can click on it or go right to it, or I can also go right back to the Power App. I'm going to head back to the Power App, and I'm just going to pretend in this case that the help desk user logged in to the app and gave more information about it. Now the CSR knows the model number, and they can complete the issue and order a new one and deliver it to the customer. At this case, the ticket is marked as completed, and now I will mark that 100% done and click update. The ticket is now marked as completed in the view of the help desk admin. Logging out and coming back in as a help desk user, I can see my ticket has been completed. Heading back over to Outlook, now I can see the message that indicates my ticket was completed and the process is done. Finally, if I go back to the help desk list and refresh the page, I can see here that this one is marked as complete now. I'd like to show you the flow behind the scenes that facilitated this whole process of sending the emails. Each time that you submit a ticket or update it in the help desk, this flow is triggered by the Power App. The Power App first queries the SharePoint list of help desk items with this get items action. If I look at advanced options, I can see that there's a filter query where I'm only returning the list item whose ID is equal to the parameter passed in the help desk Power App. This ID is passed in under the hood each time an item is created or updated in the help desk Power App. After we've returned the list item associated with the ticket that was just updated or created, we then evaluate to see what the value is for the task status value in that particular ticket. If it was not started, then we're going to fall into the first case here. In the not started case, you will notice the subject that we saw before that says there's a ticket for you and then has the title, and then it gives the link to the item. And then there's three if statements in the bottom. If I expand the if statement, I can see that there is an expression in here. I've copied and pasted all the expressions to make them easier to read. The first if statement says, if the priority value is high, then this is the message that we're going to display. This is the one that indicates the SLA is 4 hours or less. In the case that the priority was medium, then we have 8 hours to close the ticket. And like you saw, when the priority was low, we had 24 hours or less to meet the SLA. So that's a good example of how you can communicate things like that dynamically inside of a flow. In addition to that case, we also trap on the in progress, which we saw in action, where it sent the email that told the user who created the ticket that our ticket was being worked on. There's also two more cases in here. Waiting on CSR notification. This is the one where we send it to the creator of the ticket and tell them we're asking for more information. And also finally the email when the ticket was completed, we send it back to the person who created the ticket and let them know it's done. That's a quick walkthrough of the Help Desk PowerApps sample. I hope you find it helpful. If you need to learn how to do setup information about it, please see the setup documentation and the video for this particular application. Thank you.